India is a land of contrast, exploding population, and economic growth. Today, India is at a critical crossroads. Its emerging middle class has benefited from high-paying jobs in computer programming and customer service call centers. The poor are desperately turning away from the oppression and discrimination of their Hindu caste rankings. Hundreds of thousands each year are finding hope for a better life through Jesus Christ.
Places which had hardly 10, 15 churches now have thousands of house churches.
And in my network over the last 5 years, where we started the house church training and the church planting, it has grown from zero to 3,200 house churches with a cumulative strength of 32,000 believers.
This exploding interest in Christianity can be traced back to the vision and obedience of one Christian businessman. Over 200 years ago, a simple small-town English shoemaker named William Carey was moved by the stories of the horrific heathen practices in South Asia. He responded to a vision and a call from God to bring them the saving message of Jesus Christ. Compelled by his missionary calling to this distant land, William Carey dedicated his life to establish his mission works just outside of Calcutta on the banks of the Hooghly River in the small Danish settlement called Serampore. William Carey was a pioneer used by God to stimulate the beginning of God's dramatic modern-day work in India. Expect great things from God. Attempt great things for God. Carey practiced this motto. He believed that Indians should be taught to read the Bible so they could become Christians. He translated portions of the Bible into 40 different Indian languages and dialects.
He did Bible translation in such a big way that by the turn of the century, he doubled the number of translations of the Bible all over the world.
He believed that Christians needed to be educated to be leaders in all spheres of society. To accomplish that goal, he established the first university of any kind in India called Serampore College.
We have a university status which was granted by a charter given by King Frederick VI of Denmark.
The grand objective of the institution founded by Carey was the promotion of the belief in Jesus Christ's divinity and atonement, which he deemed essential to vital Christianity. Serampore education programs were open to Indians of all creeds, ethnicity, and gender, the first example of true diversity and democracy in Asia. Carey's vision and legacy is even more relevant for today. India needs leaders. Serampore is training them.
Serampore College is a mother college in India.
It's recognized by the government.
Serampore students are from every region of India, representing different denominations, states, languages, and tribal groups.
The majority of the church leaders in India today are graduates of Serampore College and affiliated colleges.
Today, 50 seminaries and colleges are affiliated and accredited through Serampore University to serve the Protestant churches of India. Serampore alumnus Reverend Obed Nayak continues the Carey vision and mission in Orissa, one of the poorest rural states of India.
My calling was church planting and preaching the gospel, winning the souls for the glory of God. In this way, Serampore College extended my vision and strengthened my vision to do the church planting ministry in my local area.
His practical gospel message is bearing fruit with hundreds of village community health education groups, micro-business self-help groups, and church plants, completing the cycle of transformational spiritual, social, and economic development. The current church leadership development methods are slowly being hard-pressed to meet the demands of today's rapid population growth and the wonderful expansion of the growing church.
Theological education is the key for development of leadership in India.
India has become a technology leader in many areas. The gospel deserves no less.
I think we have to reclaim what William Carey had begun.
William Carey used the most advanced technology of his day to build the Kingdom of God in India.
Why not rebuild the campus William Carey began and resurrect his vision and his dream of bringing the good news of Jesus Christ to the whole world?
We are rekindling that fire. The William Carey Heritage Foundation has partnered with the Council of Serampore University to revitalize and build on the visionary foundations established by William Carey.
As a council, our vision is to see that this education is at the cutting edge, addressing issues that our country is facing, becomes relevant, and equips the church in the new scenario that we find ourselves in India.
Serampore must be brought into the 21st century. That means high tech, with state-of-the-art libraries, computers, distance learning, interactive media classrooms, communications training, and leadership development curriculum. The result will be that a growing and dynamic India will be met with a growing and dynamic expression of the gospel.
This is a tremendous opportunity to leap forward. And with this sort of a start will raise credibility for the cause of the gospel among all these colleges.
Effective development of Christ-centered, compassionate leadership translates into serving more people in India with the life-changing message of Jesus, one life at a time. Centuries ago, with a hostile government, treacherous conditions, little support, and a daunting task ahead, William Carey forged into the future against all odds because he knew he was following God's call. You have the opportunity to reflect the same spirit as you prayerfully and financially invest in this historic effort to bring Christian leadership to the vital country of India. The time is right. The methods are clear. Serampore College and the William Carey Heritage Foundation have God's unique favor. Expect great things from God. Attempt great things for God.
Let us join together. I would like to invite you to come and be a part of that William Carey's legacy to change India and to change the world.